Surfshark has been making waves for more than just its low prices. So for this Surfshark VPN review, I've tested its features and capabilities, explored the apps, and uncovered both the pros and the cons. Okay, so let's start this Surfshark review with this VPN's main advantage: affordability. While the short-term Surfshark price is pretty standard, the long-term cost is among the lowest in the game. Plus, Surfshark comes with unlimited device connections, meaning you can easily share this VPN. Now, you didn't hear this from me, alright, but you can basically pull off a Spotify family situation and split the cost with your friends. However, if you truly want the lowest price, finding the biggest Surfshark discount can take some digging. Or diving, I guess, because VPNs tend to hide their best offers. So if you need it, I'll leave a link in the description that applies the latest Surfshark coupon code. Now, sadly, there's no Surfshark free plan, but there's a 30-day money-back guarantee that you can use as a DIY free trial of sorts. So we get it. This VPN is cheap, but is Surfshark good? For VPNs, the answer to that starts with privacy and security capabilities. So of course, I went to examine them. For starters, Surfshark VPN has a no-logs policy that's been independently audited, proving that they're not keeping tabs on what you're doing online. Now that's great, especially since their jurisdiction is in the Netherlands. The country might be known for tulips and killer pancakes, but privacy, not so much. They're part of the Nine Eyes Alliance, after all. If you haven't heard, it basically means mass surveillance and data sharing between the member countries. But because of this, Surfshark didn't just stop at a clean privacy policy, they doubled down by implementing RAM-based servers, which can't physically store data long term. On top of that, everything you do while connected is hidden using modern encryption. And of course, your original IP is hidden, or is it? I wanted to see this for myself, so I did some IP and DNS leak testing. It's very simple, really. First, you just run a test on ipleak.net to see your usual info. Write it down for later comparison or get with the times and take a screenshot. Then you connect to a VPN server, which is either just pressing the quick connect button or picking a country from a list. Very sleek, very simple, very demure. Once the app shows that you're connected to a VPN, run the test on ipleak.net again. See if your actual IP and DNS addresses don't pop up. If they do, that means the VPN is leaking your IP address and the connection isn't actually private. Now, obviously, Surfshark passed my test with flying colors, otherwise this video would have been named VPN Trash. And I was vigilant at testing, all right? I did it in multiple server locations all across the globe, and none of my own information was ever leaking. Now, in the case the VPN connection stumbles, there is a risk that your IP leaks then. But to counter this, Surfshark has a reliable kill switch, which, in a case like this, immediately cuts off your device's internet connection so that you're not left exposed. But with Surfshark, random disconnections are super rare. That's because in 2022, Surfshark introduced the Nexus technology, which, and I am massively oversimplifying the hell out of this, connects all of their servers into one big web server. Even if the line connection to your server is interrupted, you get automatically rerouted, providing a stable and fast connection. But that brings the question, how fast is Surfshark really? Well, to find that out, I ran another test. Just like with the IP leak testing, first you need to check your own connection. And you do that by going to speedtest.net and pressing this go button. This establishes a baseline, and then we can see how much a VPN affects your current speed. After this, you connect to a VPN server and then run the test again. First, I check the closest server speeds, which are always the fastest since the distance for the data to travel is minimal. And the speeds prove to be almost the same as my original connection. Now, the further the server is, the more the data has to travel, so you can notice a slight decrease in speeds when you're connected to servers all the way across the globe. But even then, as far as I use Surfshark, the speed doesn't really drop more than 15%. Yet while Surfshark is fast, after this Surfshark review, I've got to say, NordVPN is a tad bit faster. Not so much so that you could feel it when browsing, so I wouldn't recommend switching just for that. I'm just saying that Surfshark isn't some kind of perfect VPN, but it is damn good. It's really, really good. Especially if you need a VPN not just for privacy, but for entertainment as well. The wide country selection makes Surfshark a great VPN for streaming, and the fast speeds allow for watching stuff in 4K with no buffering. I also tested out torrenting with Surfshark, which proved to be super easy since all of their servers support P2P traffic. If you're more advanced in this area though, keep in mind that Surfshark doesn't have shiny torrenting features like port forwarding or a free SOX 5 proxy. If you need those, ProtonVPN covers the former, while NordVPN has the latter. Speaking of features though, let's see what else Surfshark VPN has in store. You've probably noticed already that the app looks pretty easy to use. And well, it is. Everything's labeled clearly, there's little explanations too. Very nice. And yet, it is packed. For starters, Surfshark has over 3,200 servers across 100 countries, which you can scroll through or just use a search bar like a normal person. Quick Connect is an option too. It automatically finds the closest and fastest server. The standard stuff's all here too, like Auto Connect or Split Tunneling, a tool that helps you select which apps use the VPN connection and which ones don't. It's just that Surfshark decided to be not like the other girls and renamed it as the Bypasser. Their double VPN feature met the same fate and got called Multi-Hop. While it's not an everyday feature, it's still pretty cool. It connects you through two VPN servers for extra anonymity, but it does significantly cut down your speeds. Now onto the cool stuff. I'm not gonna lie, my favorite thing about Surfshark right now is CleanWeb. It's a built-in ad blocker that does way more than just block ads. It also gets rid of trackers and malicious websites. But get this, if you install the Surfshark extension onto your browser, it gets rid of cookies and cookie requests. This is honestly the best thing I have ever discovered in this Surfshark VPN review. There are some more features that I am hard pressed to find elsewhere, like the static IP, which lets you set the same IP if you pick the same server, avoiding the constant verification requests from sites like Amazon or Facebook. Rotating IP is also unique. It was part of the Nexus update, and it keeps switching your IP address every few minutes to avoid cross-site tracking. The basic Surfshark subscription also includes an alternative ID feature. It's perfect for signing up for things without handing over your real email, so you can say goodbye to spam and protect your identity too. Now, I specifically mentioned the basic Surfshark subscription, because guess what? There's more. I'm talking about Surfshark ONE. This subscription adds tools like Alert, which watches out for data leaks related to your email, and a private search engine. And then a whole antivirus, an AV test certified one, with features like real-time and webcam protection. Yet somehow, the price increase from the basic plan is minimal. It turns out to be cheaper than most of the big name antiviruses. Plus, Surfshark antivirus is designed to work flawlessly together with the VPN, whereas these tools from different providers often trigger each other and refuse to play nicely with each other. And you usually need to dig deep into AV settings to fix that. So if you need an antivirus alongside a VPN, this bundle is a great choice. Overall, from this Surfshark VPN review, it's probably clear that the strongest point of this provider is still the price, but also the value you get from it. Strong privacy, fast and stable connection, and countless actually useful features. And on top of that, I was only able to find a couple of cons. So if you're considering getting Surfshark after this Surfshark review 2024, I can definitely recommend it. Just don't forget to grab it for cheaper via the discount link. All right, thanks for watching, and let me know what other VPN you'd like to see me test and review. I'll see you in the next one.